So let's think a little more deeply about loops. So the basic idea of a loop, right, is that you want to repeat the same code over and over again, either while or until a particular condition is met. And so in assembly, the basic idea is that we want to jump backwards in our code. We want to jump to an earlier label. And so there are three basic forms for doing this. The textbook gives these the name do while loops, jump to middle loops, and guarded do loops. So we'll use GoTo code in C for this. Once you translate your loop to GoTo code, it's again much easier to translate it down to assembly. So here is how you might translate a do while loop in C down to a do while loop in GoTo code. So here is the code in C. So you have a body statement, or if this is a block, you'd have everything that is in that body. And then you have a test expression. So basically, this gets translated into the following code. So we have a label up here to designate the top of the loop. We have the anything that needs to happen in the body goes here. And then we do our conditional test and our conditional jump. And so if that thing is true, we go back up to the loop and we keep executing. So that's a do while loop. Generally speaking, this is less useful for translating general purpose while loops. And so we have two other mechanisms that are going to be better for regular while loops, where you need to run the test first before running the body. So the two main mechanisms for doing this are called jump to middle and guarded do. So they just differ in how they're laid out. So a normal while loop checks the test, runs the body if it's true, and then just keeps repeating that process of checking the test and running the body if it's still true. So the jump to middle says, go ahead and jump down to the test. So basically they differ in where the test is. The jump to middle only has the test at the bottom. The guarded do has the test in two different places. It tests at the top and it also tests at the bottom. So for jump to the middle, we'll immediately skip to the testing code, which is why it's called jump to middle. We'll run that test. If it's true, we'll jump up to the body statement. And notice that this is arranged such that when you finish the body statement, the thing that you do immediately afterwards is you run the test again. Guarded do has the same basic form of the loop, except that rather than just immediately jumping to the test, you go ahead and you duplicate the test up here and you check for the negation of it. So if it is not true, then you just skip over the loop at the beginning. And so these are roughly equivalent. They're just different ways of translating the same code. It's worth thinking a little bit about how you might extend these for a for loop. So the two new things in a for loop, right, are the initialization and the update. So we still have a test and we still have a body statement. We still run the loop while the test expression is true. So it's worth thinking about where in these two templates, the jump to middle and the guarded do, where in these templates would the initialization and the update go? So I would pause the video and take a couple minutes to think about where you would put those in order to do a correct translation. So we want the initialization to happen at the very beginning. So that would go at the top of both of these. And then the update needs to happen after each loop iteration. So basically after the body statement. So the initialization goes at the top, the update goes right below the body statement.